Hello, dear friends, and welcome. It's Banjo-Tooie time. We are continuing through Cloud Cuckoo Land, and today, I'm not sure what we're gonna do. This is a grab bag, this level. And, you know, I've seen a lot of comments from people over the course of this series saying that they really like Cloud Cuckoo Land, especially now that I've started it. There's a handful of people in the comments that are like, I really like Cloud Cuckoo Land. And I'll admit, I maybe played up my dislike for this level a little too much. Let me clarify how I feel about Cloud Cuckoo Land. It's fine. It's fine. I feel like the general chaos and lack of direction is one of the reasons why I don't care for this particular for this level. But you know what? It's not bad. You know, it's not like outright terrible. I just feel like pretty strongly that I enjoy the other levels in the game better. And I think it is largely because I want to go to the other side, actually. We want to go to the other Mumbo. Mumbo plural. I think it's largely because it is, like, again, there's no sense of direction. I'm told that it was, like, leftover ideas that the devs had, that they sort of just threw all together in one level, which really makes a lot of sense, actually. So if that's the case, then you know what? Like, I don't really have a huge issue with it. I think that's kind of a unique way to use leftover assets. So, all right, y'all. Let's talk to Mumbo 2, Electric Boogaloo. What's up, Mumbo? How you doing, buddy? Ooh, big stretch, big stretch. Hello, Banjo. Mumbo has big surprise for you. Ooh, I like surprises. I do not. I don't care for surprises. How do you feel about surprises? What's the big surprise? Minji Django, crafty shaman impersonator. Har, 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 foolish bear. You fell straight into my trap. I'm not that pathetic shaman you think I am. I am mighty. I am Minji Django. Okay. As you see, there's no escape and resistance is futile. Oh, Jesus. Oh, what? He attacks me right away? My guy. And he's got the homing. Oh, this is terrible. Everything about this is bad. Terminator Mumbo. I'm not about this. I do love this boss, though. This is one of the most creative bosses in the franchise. Also, hearing, like, the Cloud Cuckoo Land, or not the Cloud Cuckoo Land, the, Mumbo theme. Mumbo's theme as a boss theme is really cool. But that also means we did not get a Cloud Cuckoo Land boss theme, although I believe that Grant Kirkhope made one? I think I heard one many, many years ago that he, like, released later. Sorry, this is like taking all of my focus. Dude, don't be up there. That's cheating. You can actually hit him while he's teleporting around to get in extra hits. I'm like not worried about dying because I have honey back, so. Of course, as you do damage to him, he is gonna teleport faster and faster. So it is within your best interest if he does appear like immediately next to you to be able to, ooh, yeah. And also like not getting hit on the one right before he starts tapping his wand. I like jumping around and moving because then the homing kind of gets a little confused. Don't teleport away. Hell yeah. It might be the best I've ever done in this boss fight. Although, I have honey back, so, like, there's really no losing this fight for me. The amount of time it takes for him to fire another shot is the amount of time it takes for my health to come back. Bzzah. I calculate my chances of stopping are now minimal. What a creative boss fight, dude. I'm so happy about that. I'm also told that the boss fights are random between like the two appearances of Mumbo. One of them is actual Mumbo, one of them is Minji Django. And I got like really lucky just happening across regular Mumbo first. So there you go, there you have it. Cool beans, Minji Django, done. God, what a weird place. Boop, 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 boop. These guys are annoying the shit out of me. Like, I hate coming into this cavern because of these guys. Fortunately, most everything is outside the cavern, though. And the other thing is, too, is, like, even though there's only one warp to the center, it's pretty easy to get around this level because there's fly pads everywhere, so you can kind of just fly wherever you need to go. And somebody pointed out, and I think you guys are making me like this level more by like, telling me things that are really kind of positive about it. I do like, because I hadn't really thought about it much, but I do like the sort of, like, trying to figure out the strategy to get Banjo and Kazooie to go certain areas. Because, like, that's the challenge, right? The challenge is, like, where can you get with Banjo and Kazooie? Where can you take them? Successfully. That's the big puzzle. And honestly, like, getting Kazooie around, not too bad. But getting Banjo around town, not easy. Especially when there's Zubbas. Hi. So last time we did summon actual real Mumbo to help us grow. That is also, I think, the last time we're gonna use Mumbo in the whole game. I don't think there's another time we're gonna be using Mumbo. That's kind of sad, actually. Aw. Well, anyway, we use Mumbo to grow these beanstalks so we can get up here and do the sack race. Hello, show me your sack.
There you are, Furball. Event 2 is the sack race. Find a sack from somewhere and race me to the finish line.
Hey, guess what? That's not the sack. I mean, I'm in the sack, but the wrong way. Put the feet in the sack.
I see, you have feet in a sack. Fancy a little race across this thorny course?
Is the course thorny or are you thorny? 3, 2, 1, go, let's go. I'm gonna cheat. I don't give a shit. You think I'm gonna do this legitimately? You have not met me. Sir, I have honey back. What did you expect? What? You must have cheated. Oh, he caught me. You ain't won yet, Furball.
See you around for event 3.
There we go, event 3. Is event 3 a proper real race? Let's do a regular ass race, man. So we did the first one with both Banjo and Kazooie. We did the second one as Banjo. And I believe the third one can only be done as Kazooie, because I think Kazooie goes faster with the running shoes when Banjo isn't weighing her down. Ow. It's fine. Rah. Get your wiener off me, dude. I do not want you to touch me with your wiener. My God. Ask first. Then maybe we'll talk. Buy me dinner? Candy is not dinner? Stop it! Cease? Cease and desist? Am I gonna have to send a letter? Am I gonna have to talk to your parents? Freakos. Stop it! I hate this so much. I guess I could have just murdered Banjo in cold blood to get back here, but see, that's why I do that. I just throw them off the side to teleport them back to each other. Bum 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 hum bum hum bum bum. At least Kazooie can kill him faster. That's the thing I don't like about Banjo's attack. It's just super duper slow. All right, nerd. I see you have your running shoes on. Do you think you could beat me to the finish line and gold medal? Yeah, I think so. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go! Yeah, I mean, look at that. He's like almost as fast as me. And I'm pretty sure if you come here as Banjo and Kazooie, you can't do that. But maybe I'm wrong. I could be wrong about that. I lost! I can't believe I was beaten by a bag of feathers. Take my medal. I'm off to the gym to train for my next season. Yeah, you do look like you need a little bit more training, perhaps. Like, I'm not gonna, like, judge or whatever here, but I do think you need that in your life. Okay, let me think. What do I want to do next? Let's do the pot of gold. I like the pot of gold. How do I get there? Is it through here? I think it's through here. Dude, really? Burbo? Pot of gold. I'm told that you can do this with just Kazooie if you just wanted to, like, glide over. But you gotta hit this button first. And I don't know that you can make that glide. Because it's a little bit up. So I don't think you can make the glide over there. But maybe you can if you're real clever. Like, if you do the backflip with Kazooie and then glide over. But will it be fast enough to make it? I don't know. Probably. You do get, like, enough time, I think. This is such a neat place. Inside the pot of gold. There's also a wait a minute. I have all the red Jinjos. Sir? No! Okay, I'm not gonna touch you. Stop, leave me alone. Oh my God, he's chasing me down! No, bro's insane! Little bro's insane! Look at him! Burn him! Jesus! Chill out, my guy. Holy shit, man. Ow. Rude. Okay, so here we go. Shooting all four eggs in here spawns the gold eggs and also makes the walls light up with jiggies. How many of these jiggies can we get? Under the time limit? Welcome, you're my fabled pot of gold shooting challenge. To win an ill-deserved prize, you must hit at least 75 jiggies in 45 seconds. If you manage to beat 90, I will give you an extra prize. I reckon you won't even hit 20. Fancy a go? Yeah, I think there's something like 100 or 110 jiggies on the wall. And it's possible to get all of them. I will not be doing that. I'm going to get as many as I need to win, which is, what, 90? And this is probably the best way to do it, is line up and try to go like a certain speed to where you can shoot all of them. It's not too bad to get all of them if you do it like this. The real difficulty is coming to the, like, getting the reticle to stay where you want it to. Okay, I got the 75. But I really, really need 90. Okay, so I got the 90. Let's see if I can get the rest of them. No. Yeah, I think there is only like 100 maybe. But I got both the prizes anyway. I always found that to be pretty easy if you just spin around in circles. If you try to just like aim willy-nilly and go all over and clear like one wall at a time, you will never do it. Oh, hit all 100. Okay, so it is 100. Should I do it? Should I try to do it? No. I've done it before. Get lost then. You don't get anything extra anyway. It'd be kind of neat if you got like an extra cheat or something, like a hidden prize, but I don't think you get anything. Look at that, y'all. 79 jiggies, man. 79 jiggies. We are 11 jiggies away from finishing this video game right now. How does that make you feel? I'm very excited. I'm starting to think about what we're doing next after Banjo-Tooie. You know, I'm sure there's something. I've got a few ideas. Perhaps I'll return and finish Cavern of Dreams at some point. It's a game that I really want to play the entirety of. So we'll see what happens. Was there a fly pad down there that I missed? I think there actually is a fly pad, like, right down there. Or maybe not. Okay. Well, there's a couple thoughts that I had. Let's go in this basin first. So that we can get a backtrack jiggy. A jiggy that we haven't talked about in a while. So like right down here in the middle of this water basin that we filled with water. Actually, I don't think we filled it with water. I think the water was already here. I was gonna say we filled it with water when we talked to Mumbo, but no. This just so happens to be perfectly aligned with the one, the only pterodactyl land, and perfectly aligned with Dippy's hole. Drippy, not Dippy. Dippy, Drippy. Yippee! My pool is full of water. Where did it all come from? Duh! Chased heavenly.
Well, it did come from the clouds, Dippy.
Did it? You said it wouldn't just drop from the sky.
I lied. Just drink it and be happy.
Oh, I am. Here, take my odd-shaped gold tooth in exchange.
So one of my favorite Banjo-Kazooie tropes is when the characters don't know what jiggies are, so they describe them as something else. Like, here's my gold trinket. Here's my trophy. Here's my prize. Here's my gold tooth. It's one of my favorite Banjo tropes. Okay. Well, I think next up, mayhaps, we shall do a flying. Do I have, I know what we should do next. Let's go back to the front. Yeah, someone's in the air. Defend your jiggy at all costs. We'll do that later. I'm not going to do that right now. Actually, can I do that right now even? I don't think you can even do this right now. I think you need the transformation. So we'll come back and we'll do that at a later point. Fortunately, you can beak bomb at will here forever and ever and ever and get around the whole world super, super easy. Do I have a Globo? I have one Globo, but I used it on Mumbo, didn't I? I didn't get the second Globo yet, did I? I do not remember where the second Globo is even. Ow, dick. Look who it is! Hey, young man. I'm George Ice Cube, stuck up here at this perilous altitude.
What happened, George?
I was out walking on the icy side of Hellfire Peaks with my wife, Mildred, when a huge blizzard came along and blew me away.
Why not stay up here?
Lovely view.
I'm afraid of heights. Now, I reckon I'm above the icy side, so if you could just give me a little push.
Sure, no problem, George. Good luck finding your wife. I hope she's still waiting for you and hasn't left you. You know what, George? I have an admission of guilt. I'm sorry to tell you this, but your wife, Mildred, I killed her. Okay, bye!
Mildred! No, wrong side. Tell Mildred I love her.
Oops. My bad. My bad, dog. Sorry about that. Oopsie poopsie. Was not my intention. Oh, hold up. Wait. I know I already did this, but I might as well at least check in there because I don't know if there's any. There might be like notes and or Jinjos hidden in some of these holes. There's also an additional piece of dialogue when you open up the super stash. I just wanted to try and get, oh, there's the other Globo. I had a feeling it was around here somewhere. I wasn't sure if it was in that hole or not. Hello? I touched you. I also think there's maybe some notes in here. Yeah. They kind of spread the notes out pretty far and wide around this level, too. Okay, we're gonna go immediately back out. Let's go do maybe the transformation stuff? Mayhaps? Oh, that also means I have something else to do. Maybe the worst thing in this video game. There she is. The worst thing in this video game. A scourge. A cancer on the otherwise perfectly beautiful game. It's her. It's Canary Mary. Should we do it now? All right. Let's do it. Oh, I'm sorry I set you on fire. I'm not actually sorry. Hey, Banjo, it's that crazy canary woman again.
Hey, that's me! How about we go on another race?
But the hand cart's still down on the mine.
Don't worry! You could use this clockwork mouse I found instead.
Clockwork mouse? Are you mad?
Oh, yes! Oh, go on, jump on board and press X as fast as you can to power the mouse along.
Okay. Okay. So two things. One, this is the dreaded challenge that everyone dreads in this game. Okay, number one. Number two, when I was a kid, when I was a teenager and the Xbox version came out, I could not physically do this challenge. And what I ended up doing is pulling out my Rock Band drum set and doing a drum roll on the blue pad, which would be equivalent to the X button. And yes, that does work on the Xbox version. So that's how I ended up winning this. I've since learned the tricks. There are some tricks. They don't always work perfectly. And you can mess it up. So wish me luck. The first one's not too bad. I'm gonna do the rolling thumb trick where you just like kind of sort of roll the controller back and forth. I'm gonna do that to start. Should be able to do this first challenge pretty easily. And then I will attempt the second half of this challenge doing the same method. That's my goal anyway. And see, the other thing is too that you have to remember is that rhythm is more important than speed. You can only go so fast, and rhythm is important. So if you just keep up the same rhythm throughout the whole race. Now, unfortunately, the second race here, longer than the first one. Kind of fucked up, actually. You go further in the second one, in addition to it being much harder. But I'm gonna try it the legitimate way, and if I can't do it the legitimate way, I'm gonna try my special method, and we'll talk about that when we get there. Oh no, you didn't. Look at what I found up here. It's a gold tooth. I also found another papery thing. Hop on the mouse if you want to try and win it. If I must. Here, let me get the jiggy first. All right, here we go. I'm gonna go fast. I'm not gonna. So the secret method is that she has some rubber band. Oops. Please reconnect controller. Did I accidentally? I think I accidentally unsynced my controller. One sec. Okay. Let's try not to hit that button again. Okay. So she has rubber banding. So like, if you stay just behind her, she'll go kind of slow. But I'm gonna try to just go as fast as I can and see what happens. My arms are literally burning. It's fine. Pause method is a legitimate strat. Okay, ready? Look how fast she goes at the end. Holy shit, but I did do it the legitimate way. I didn't do the rubber band strat. I didn't do the drum roll strat. All I did was the pause strat one time. All right, be impressed. God, I need some water after that. Well, that's it then. I reckon I'll be off for my dinner. What are you having? A nice worm sandwich and a tasty bag of Millet? I don't even know what Millet is. How about a third race and let us try to win your dinner? Ugh. Well, no, you'd probably win and then I'd go hungry. See you around, fellow bird and bear buddy. I hope I never see you again, Canary Mary. In fact, actually, we never do see Canary Mary again. She is gone, maybe dead. Hopefully. Whew. That was a workout, though, huh? Really gets that upper body strength going, you know? Hot diggity damn. There's a Jinjo in here, right? Yeah, there's a Jinjo up there. Can I get that with a clockwork egg instead? Surprisingly worked well, actually. All right. Wumba, what's up, girl? You have Globo, want to give to Humba? Yes, please. I'm pleasantly surprised at how quickly I did that Canary Mary. Usually I have to retry it at least once. All right, guys. Time for a throwback. You ready for the throwback of the century? That's right. It's B Banjo. Wumba call this B. Press A to jump and A again when in air to fly. Use left stick to steer and press A to fly also. Press L or R to shoot stingers. So that's the big upgrade that Humba Wumba gives you over the B from the first game. I think the only transformation in the first game that had any sort of attack was the crocodile, technically, because you could go chomp, chomp, chomp with the crocodile. But, in this game, every single transformation has an attack to some degree. Yeah, let's do the eyeball flowers first. Wait, I didn't see where she sent it. Crap. I actually think that you can go to any of them and kill any of them. Is there one over here? No? Yeah, I think you can go to any of them and kill any of them at any time. Even the one that doesn't have the Jiggy in it. Oh, they all show as if they have the Jiggy in them. Unless that was the one it went to, but... But if you follow the yellow brick road here, you can kind of get a hint as to where they might be. Zoop, 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 zoop. God, I saw where that went, and I still don't know where it went. I think it's here. How many of these are there? Five? My rare eyeballs, Jiggy implants. You've killed them all. Here we go. Dude, we're blowing through this level right now, actually. I don't think I've ever done this level as fast as I'm doing it right now. Usually I get like sort of lost and like overwhelmed at the amount of stuff to do. Now shoot this lots of times. Okay. Easy. Nice shooting. Why not come inside? All right. We're doing lots of shooting and spinning today. Besides the mazes that you have to go through. Why am I in first person? Besides the mazes that you have to go through in first person, all of the shooting games are easily done by just standing in the middle and shooting in circles. Pretty much. Almost all of them can be done that way. It's a little disorienting, actually. Do you need any instructions? I do not. It's the same as every other shooting game. Red bees are worth one. Green bees are worth two. Blue bees are worth three. And actually, I think you can do this standing still, but there's not really any point because when you're flying, not only are your shots homing, you can also rapid fire them. I don't think you can rapid fire from the ground. So it's literally just like come in the middle, fly around in circles until you vomit and sort of like adjust a little bit if you see a color. It's like pretty easy. Fly up once in a while. I didn't see how many points I needed, but I don't think I'll have any trouble with that. You can also use the L button to fly to turn faster in the air and make yourself even more vomit-induced. So if you're sick and you need to throw up to feel better, just come play this and hold L and go like this. I'm sorry, look away. Everyone look away. I think I got enough. I think it's like 65 or 70. Nice shooting, you scored enough to win second prize.
But you also had enough to get first prize. Blah.
Amazing! You also got enough to win the first prize. I like the Zubbos. I'm glad they brought them back. Big fan of bees here. Shoutouts to bees. They're like good for the environment or something. Cause like pollination, I guess, you know? Flowers are good, bees are good, it's all good. Honey's good, we like honey. Right? All right. Do you want to play again? No. So I think we're missing just one Cheeto page in the entire game, if I'm correct. Let me take a moment here to look at my totals. No, that's all the Cheeto pages, right? Unless there's one like in a previous level or in the overworld that I'm missing. Which means that I should have five currently. Yes, okay, I got confused because I saw four down in the corner when I collected it, but that's because the Zubbos had to talk to me. All right, let me think if there's anything else I need to do as the bee first before I do anything. Let me just see if this is a Jiggy that I can get as the bee. Because I'm not sure. So there's this tiny hole. Okay, yeah, you can't fit through the tiny hole as the tiny bee. You have to be even smaller than that. Screw you! I'm your friend! We are literally brothers from another mother. Why? Rude and unusual, strange individuals. I think that's it for the bee. If there's anything I'm missing, I'll go back and get it, but I think that's it. There might be like one more thing. I feel the great need to get at least one more Jiggy, but this is honestly the perfect stopping point. So, you know, maybe I'll just keep recording after this. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you guys. Thanks for supporting on Patreon. Some big stuff is going down over on Patreon very soon. So if you're a supporter over there, go check out your email inboxes. Go check out Patreon. So thanks for that. And I will see you guys in the next one.